not a game. It's a rich thing.
So I've been invited to be a guest on a radio program this morning. It's going to be for 11 a.m. to 12 a.m. But I woke up this morning, yeah, and then I went onto Instagram. Then I saw this particular Instagram influencer, a particular brand paid Instablog to do an entire whole announcement of them signing up this influencer as their brand ambassador. And then they went ahead to talk about how they love this person's skin, this person's sense of style, and that is why they announced this person or selected this person to be their brand ambassador. And I didn't really read the entire article. Yeah, who has that kind of time? I didn't really read everything, but I was just asking myself, like, okay, was this actually necessary? Like, is this the right way to actually market your product? Is this the right way to actually do things? Anyways, I'm going to be talking about all of that on this video, guys. Before I continue, I just want to say welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Gloria Elijah, and this is Frankly Speaking with Glory, the girl with the tea. This morning, I've got a literal steaming hot tea, yes, because I'm trying to kick back my mojo. And also, the tea for this video is basically just to chat about, or basically just to ask you guys that question: what are your thoughts? What do you think about brands announcing people as their brand ambassadors? Do you think they are doing it the right way? Do you think announcing influencers as brand ambassadors for your brand, for your business, is going to increase sales? Is going to create more awareness? Why is it even necessary? What are your thoughts? I have my own reservations about it, which I'm going to be sharing on this video today. But I'm asking you guys to go ahead and let me know about your thoughts. You can do so in the comment section below. Let's just start. So I'm going to be using a couple of celebrities whom I admire and whom I have seen how they silently work with brands, and they also get results without any major announcement of them being the brand ambassador for such brands. Now, the first person I'm going to be talking about is Genevieve Najif. I do not live with her. I'm not a friend. I see her as my friend virtually. I don't know anything about Genevieve Najif aside the fact that she's a public figure, she's an actor, she's a producer, an amazing human being, yes. But one thing I have come to notice about Genevieve is whenever she uses any single product, any single item, and she puts a picture of that item on any of her social media accounts or pages or wherever, you will see people rushing to go and get that particular item, whether she tags the brand or not. As far as, hey, it is Genevieve that used this thing, you will see people rushing to go and buy it. Guys, that is silent subliminal marketing, and it works amazingly well. Now, another celebrity whom I really, really love is Toke Makinwa. Now, aside, is it the Oppo phone? Besides the Oppo phone that Toke Makinwa was kind of silently announced as the brand ambassador for, there's so many things that Toke Makinwa uses on a daily basis. Aside her own TM brand, you know, that she flaunts on a daily basis, you know, pushing for people to patronize her on. But any other items, even before she launched her TM brand, anything, whether it is shoes, whether it is clothes, whatever Toke Makinwa wears, whatever perfume she uses on Snapchat, on Instagram, on Twitter, anywhere, the moment she puts it on her page and then she probably tags the brand, you will see how people will be rushing to buy those things. And sometimes it eventually leads to sold out situations, you know. But these are people that are actually silently influencing brands without any major announcement being made, and people are just rushing ahead to just buy those products because, hey, it is this particular celebrity that is using it. Now, let's fast forward now to Bibi Naija housemates, because I don't know, I have a strong feeling that it is with these Bibi Naija housemates that are always majorly announced by brands as being the brand ambassador that this whole thing started. Yeah, so let's fast forward to the Bibi Naija housemates that are always announced. So what happens today? They are announced as brand ambassador, and then that very deal, because of the fan competition, you know, their fan base wants to compete, they want to hold their bragging right, they want to show that, hey, we are the ones that support our favorite the most. That very day after the announcement, you will see all of them, they would rush to outlets, they will buy that particular product. Sales will be major for that particular day, or probably that particular week. And then after that week, what happens next? Guys, let's be frank with each other. What happens next? Do you honestly think, I catch that insect, you are dead. Do you honestly think that after that week, do you honestly think that that particular business would experience that same amount of sales that they experienced in that week of announcing that Bibi Naija housemate as their brand ambassador? Guys, do you honestly think that it's going to be the same? Okay, so this is what I'm trying to say, guys. From you, I feel like it is best for brands not to always constantly feel that there is a need to announce influencers as brand ambassadors. Guys, I follow a couple of influencers online, and a lot of times, in fact 100% of the time, I would personally rather patronize the brands that they tag on their post, simply because when they use the products of those brands they represent, I like the way it looks on them. God, I've been holding this tea for so long, but it's really, really hot. I can't drink it. Yeah, personally, I would rather patronize those brands simply because the way they use it, it looks good on them. The way they represent the brand, it looks good on them. But the moment I smell that they are a brand ambassador to that brand, guys, personally, I will not want to patronize the brand, because this is the thing about human beings. It's a human psychology kind of thing. This is the thing about human beings, yeah? If the person representing that brand is not a major public figure, if the person representing that brand does not hold a strong influence over my preference as an individual, if the person representing that brand, if I am not really a fan of that particular kind of product that that person is representing, guys, trust me, there's nothing that person will do, there's nothing that person will say that will make me buy that product. I just will not. And also, there's also this thing about human beings, because I like you, you're now brand ambassador for these people, okay, so what next? You know, the last thing on my mind as a consumer is I don't want to feel obliged to patronize a brand just because the person I like is actually a brand ambassador to that brand. Okay, maybe for the first few weeks, I might want to just show support and patronize the brand. Okay, so what if I don't like the product? What if it's not my thing? What if it's not my style? What if I do not like that particular kind of product? You know, I would definitely feel like I'm being forced to buy that thing. So let's do a tiny survey now. If you belong to any fan base, let's say any Bibi Naija fan base, if you belong to any Bibi Naija fan base, ever since your favorite was announced as brand ambassador to a particular business or a particular organization or a particular brand, pray tell, after that week of launching, after that week they announced that person, and you patronize them just because you want to show your support, let's be honest with ourselves. I mean, this is 1 year over, this is 2 years over, or this is probably 4-6 months over. Do you still patronize that brand because your favorite is actually affiliated with that brand? If your answer is yes, let me know in the comment section below. But guys, let's be very, very frank with each other. I know a lot of people that would not even bother. Love will not even bother. For them, we've earned the bragging right, yes, so we move. Let's move on to the next one. And the very, very realistic thing is, a lot of brands, you know, they've complained several times that they normally do not get value for their money when they go ahead to choose brand ambassadors. So sometimes most brands would rather want to do what they call PR. So what they do is they'll send packages of their product to different influencers on social media, and then what these influencers would do is they would use the products and then they would tag, you know, the brand that they are actually using. So that way, because of how they have used the product or the service and it looks really, really great or it comes out really, really well, people will be moved to go and actually patronize the brand. I prefer it that way. But the thing with human beings is when you announce, start doing major announcements, major this, major that, people would feel like they are now obliged, you know, to actually buy that thing because the person they like is actually affiliated to that thing. I don't know if you guys are understanding the perspective I'm coming from right now, but I'm just going to be very, very frank with you guys. There was a time I was constantly using a particular body cream, and I still use that body cream actually, and a lot of my subscribers would constantly ask me, oh Gloria, what do you use on your skin? Your skin is glowing, we love the way your skin looks, you know, your skin looks soft, okay, what cream do you use, what blah 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 blah. And then I would tell them the name of the cream. And guys, frankly speaking, I am not affiliated with that brand in any way. The only thing that connects me to that brand is because I love the cream and I use it on my skin and I'm seeing amazing results, as you guys can see right now. I love it, you know. And then I did not know that some of my subscribers actually took this serious. So what they started doing was they started going ahead to hunt for the cream. I mean, we're talking about subscribers that are coming from the US, Canada. They will tell me, oh Glory, please look for the cream for me, I'll pay for shipment and everything. And I'll tell them, okay, check on this particular platform, check on that platform to see if you can get it. But they will not be able to get it, so they will still tell me to help them go ahead and look for it. So one of those days, I went to Yaba, I went to a cosmetic store, and I saw one of my subscribers actually buying that same cream. And the person saw me, and the person was like, frankly speaking, I'm like, hey, Jesus Christ. You know, so that was how I met this person. The person told me that, oh my God, that looking at my skin, they love the color of my skin. So that is why she as well went on the hunt for that cream. So guys, what I did not know that I was doing some sort of subliminal marketing. You know, I was using this product, it was making me look great, and these people love it. Even the ones that do not even ask, they are going ahead to buy it, and then they will still come back and give testimonials of, oh, I bought this thing and you look great on me and I like it. Point I'm trying to make with all these ramblings is this, guys. This is a message to big brands, small brands, as long as you are a business providing product or service, you're a brand, you know. So whatever you are, this is just an advice. I feel like it's completely overrated announcing influencers as brand ambassadors. What you should be looking out for is how to make sales. What you should be looking out for is how to actually get more publicity and create more awareness for your products, for your services. It's not about, okay, maybe to some extent it's about the influencer per se, but at the end of the day, after announcing the influencer and all, and you still do not make sales, what is the point of it all? You know, so basically, if I were to do things differently, I would rather, you know, do PR. I would rather get a bunch of influencers, give them samples of my products, tell them to use it, and please tag me. I believe that that way I will get more, you know, more value for my money, especially when the influencer does not really have, because it's one thing to be an influencer on social media, and it's another thing to actually be an influencer offline. So what if the two does not have the same capacity? What if the two does not have the same level of influence? You know, so how is that going to work? Anyways, guys, some people might have different thoughts about this, but this is just what I think. This is what I think. Brands need to understand that there's the online market and there's the offline market. So why not invest more in the offline market? Yeah, and then for the online market, why not just go ahead and, you know, send samples of your products to as many influencers as you can and let them tag you and let them do, you know, subtle marketing for you, rather than just, getting just one brand ambassador. You do one major announcement, and after that, no more sales. You now sit down and start wondering the next step for your life. Anyways, guys, this is where I'm going to stop this video. I really look forward to knowing what you guys think about it. I know that a lot of you are marketing experts on here. So please, I really, really want to know your thoughts about this one. So kindly go ahead and drop your thoughts, your suggestions, your contributions in the comment section below, and I will definitely respond to all of you. That's it, guys. Don't forget to join me by 11 a.m. on Last Giddy Radio 90.1 FM if you are in Lagos or Ogun State, okay? I'm going to be engaged in a debate about New Year resolutions or nay, yay or nay, on radio this morning. So I'll see you guys on the other side. Oh, and don't forget, I'm going to also be live streaming on YouTube. So even if you're not in Lagos, you're going to catch up with me live on YouTube. And another thing is, we're going to be having that debate in Pidgin. So if you don't understand Pidgin, don't worry, I'll interpret. See you guys. Bye.